Good evening, at least at the time of recording. I may present you our contribution of post-fire behavior of structural stainless steel. It's a collaboration between KU Leuven, Brunel University and Tampere University. You can see the content of our presentation on the slide, and you will see that we will treat several topics to finally arrive to some conclusions. Stainless steel becomes more and more popular due to a number of product properties which are listed on the slide. For post-fire behavior, the low thermal conductivity and excellent behavior at high temperatures are in the scope of interest of our contribution. Now we come to our research questions. How does stainless steel behave following a fire, and compared to carbon steel, where are we? So we see here in the figure the reduction of our material properties from the, in this case, the proof strength of stainless steel and the elastic modulus or the Young modulus. If you look into a real fire, then we see that the load level is deemed to be reduced. The steel gets hot, which is indicated in a red color here, and then is cooling down, is perhaps partially dismantled, which is the reason why the load level is going down. But we want to rely at the end, after a fire, on the design load level, which is higher than the one which was in case of fire. So, looking to carbon steel, we see that carbon steel can maintain his yield strength till a temperature of about 400 degrees Celsius, but then it is rapidly decreasing, and at a temperature of about 650 degrees Celsius, both curves are switching. So it means that above 650 degrees Celsius, till 1000 degrees Celsius, the capacity of our stainless steel in yield or proof strength is much higher than the one of carbon steel. Also, the elastic modulus is superior to the one of the carbon steel. If you take a look to the actual published tests, then we will see that the load level during the heating is zero, and then afterwards the specimen becomes loaded till to failure. So a second research question is rising. Will this load history influence the mechanical properties of our stainless steel in post-fire conditions? To capture this problem, a loaded beam was subjected to fire, unloaded, coupons are taken out of the web and the flange of the beam and subjected to a mechanical test until the failure. And finally, then we come to the last research question. Can we develop a reliability-based methodology to perform post-fire assessments of structures? Let's discuss the experimental program. At Tampere University, a cellular beam was loaded until 30% of the design load and submitted to an ISO fire. After 36 minutes, failure was observed due to a post buckling at the right hand side of the figure, and the test was stopped. From this beam, some test coupons are taken, like shown on the figure, and tested at Tampere University. Out of the same batch of material, but virgin material, like we call it, because it was not yet loaded. Also, equal test coupons are taken and tested this time at Brunel University. Test samples out of the loaded beam do show similar behavior. All results are quite close to each other. Exception is the D region, which is the web at the left-hand side, while at the right-hand side, at the same location, web post buckling occurred and induced the failure. The F sample is seen as an outliner. If we compare these results with the ones taken out of virgin material, submitted to fire but not loaded during the fire, we see a similar behavior as the ones which are shown here. It should be clear that the scale at the horizontal axis is a little bit different, and for that reason we highlight the same region at the right figure, which is showed at the left hand side figure. To facilitate some statistical data processing, we extended our proper results with a number of peer-reviewed papers, which are all dealing with post-fire material properties of stainless steel. And at that moment, we arrived till about 270 tests, which is a nice data set. All 270 tests are shown in this figure. The austerity grades are presented by circular dots. The open dots indicate our proper test results. The duplex grades are presented by the square dots and triangle dots, indicating ferritic grades. Eurocode 0 proposes to use with a log normal distribution for material properties. So, for a classic value of a material property, this equation becomes valid. We've got a mean value, a Kn factor, and a standard deviation. The subscript y means that a log normal value is behind it. So we've got the mi value is the mean value of the i, and that is the mean value of the log normal values of the original x values. For standard deviation, a simplification can be made as long as vx is smaller than about 0.2, following Eurocode and XD, but even till 0.4, this approximation is quite close to reality. So finally, we arrive to this Kn factor, and this Kn factor is given in a table and copied just from Eurocode 0 and XD. It should be noted that for an n value which is infinite, the Kn becomes 1.64. We assume now that the coefficient of variation that we observed during the tests out of the statistical data set, that it is a composition of two independent variables, the coefficient of variation of the ambient properties and the one which are changed due to the post-fire behavior. So it means that we've got a kind of a coefficient of variation at ambient conditions. Then we're going to have a reduction of our properties due to the heating. We're going to have a recovering factor due to the cooling. And finally, we end at a retention factor. And this retention factor, this will be the subject of the post-fire coefficient of variation. To avoid some noise in this retention factor, with fluctuating values going up and going down, we propose to use an operator. This means that the value for a higher temperature can never be higher than the previous one, because this retention factor should be descending, you see it, and that the maximum value is kept out of the value which was observed from that temperature or the mean value of the previous and the next one. By doing so, we arrive to austenitic grades, for example, the proof strength. And we see that this proof strength is quite constant till about 750 degrees Celsius. It's only slightly lesser than in ambient conditions, while the reduction factor was quite important. If we take a look to the ultimate strength, we observe almost no degradation of the material. For the ultimate strain, and the ultimate strain together with the ultimate strength and the proof strength will be needed at the moment that we want to use more advanced methods for the design of our stainless steel, like in the continuous strength method, we see that after about 250 degrees Celsius, there is a small reduction and then it stays constant. And this same can be said about the Young modulus or the modulus of elasticity. And this gives an overview. Similar things are observed for the duplex, a lesser amount of data, but we see that for the proof strength, there is a reduction starting a little bit earlier at 500 degrees Celsius. For the ultimate strength, almost no reduction. The ultimate strain, it stays constant. And the Young modulus, we see a two-step behavior. For ferritic grades, we see a more important reduction of the proof strength, almost no reduction in the ultimate strength. The ultimate strain, there is a two-step, and the Young modulus is almost not influenced by the post-fire behavior. To assess the safety level of our structure, which survived the fire, we have still to solve some reliability issues. Eurocode 0 proposes this equation to derive in a direct way the design value, By this, you can calculate also the safety factor, because the safety factor is nothing more than the ratio between the characteristic value and the design value. And the characteristic value was shown before, which results finally in this figure. And you can present this in a graphical way, or with the coefficients of variation, or with the safety factor format. And the safety factor format means that the final safety factor is a product of the safety factor for ambient conditions, which is 1.1, and the one following the post-fire event. And it can be seen that till 550, the 1.1 is kept almost constant, and then we've got a second step, a third step, and a fourth step. But this is based with a reliability index of 3.8. At the moment that we descend our reliability index to 3.3, because it's an existing building, of course, it has been submitted to fire, so it should be existing, otherwise it's not possible. Then we arrive to this figure. And we can do even the same with 3.1, which is also suggested in literature. And we see that the difference between 3.3 or 3.1 is not so important. Moreover, we see that our factor, which is the post-fire factor, becomes about 1 up to 550, and is about 1.2 up to 800 degrees Celsius. To end, some conclusions. The load history and the cooling method do have no impact on the post-fire mechanical properties. And it is demonstrated that based on the literature review and the statistical data processing, that we can retain most of our mechanical properties up to 800 degrees Celsius. And moreover, it seems that the safety factor can be kept constant 1.1, the one of ambient conditions, up to 550 degrees Celsius, and then should be slightly adapted to 1.2 at the moment that the structure has been submitted to temperatures till 800 degrees Celsius. Above, then it becomes more problematic. Time for questions and answers, and thank you for your attention.